Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we had already finished our chapter 8 and complete summary introduction of like understanding of concept of that chapter, that is wind, storm and cyclones. Along with the picture also we have done. So today I am going to start with the introduction of our next chapter, that is soil. Now a soil is not new for you all, since you all are playing in the playground, so soil is there only. Your clothes will get dirty with that soil. And different like plants or different crops can be grown by using different soils. That also you are aware of it, that different types of soils are also there. Now upper layer of our earth is made up of soil, that the most fertile soil that we found in the upper layer. Then we have some stones also, then different part of that soil is there. Now if I'll talk about what is soil, then you can say that the uppermost layer of the earth is known as soil. Now this layer consists of sand, mud and rock particles. So a simple definition also, you can see this picture of soil also, the uppermost layer of earth. What is soil? The uppermost layer of the earth is known as soil. Then this layer consists of sand, mud and rock particles. All such kind of a particles you will be finding in this uppermost layer. Then you must have heard this second word also. Now what is soil? The definition is finished with these two points, like the uppermost layer of earth is known as soil. Now this layer consists of sand, mud and rock particles. So this will complete the definition of soil. You can write it down, you just jot down these points somewhere. Then what is humus? Humus, this word we have heard many times. Humus content will increase the fertility of the soil. Humus is what? And which microorganism or microorganism eating this humus only will increase the fertility of the soil? So what is humus? Then the answer is consists of dead and decaying plants and animals remains called humus. Humus consists of dead and decayed plants and animals remains called humus. So in the villages you find it out that cow dung that is collected on one place. So that is also humus. Even the leaves and now the waste product of plants which we will be getting, like sticks, leaves, dried leaves which fallen from the trees, that will be collected on one place. So that is your humus. So humus consists of dead and decaying plants and animal remains. So now humus is same everywhere. Humus is what? That is humus is dead and decaying plants and animals remains, which is called humus. Now next, what is weathering? Now these are the certain concept which we are going to find it out, that in this chapter, like soil is deteriorating by weathering only. So I will understand first this, what is weathering. Now weathering is what? The breakdown of rocks is known as weathering. Now Breakdown of rocks means what? Means like sometimes that rock of that particular place is getting broken down and deteriorating at some places. Now the breaking down of rocks is known as weathering. Wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil to places. Now wind, water, frost help in transporting of soil to places. Now wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil to places. Now weathering is what, like the breaking down of rocks is known as weathering. Means there are certain reasons or certain places, certain reasons due to which this weathering will be done. That is, breaking down of rocks is known as weathering, and this can be done. Now wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil to places. Now there are two types of weathering. First is physical weathering and the second is chemical weathering. Two types of weathering we will find it out, physical weathering and chemical weathering. Now physical weathering, see here in this slide, this second point, like wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil in soil to places. Now wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil to places means that is, that is like when wind flows, moving air allows to take the upper layer of the soil along with them only. Then water and frost helps in transporting of soil to some places. Now there are two types of weathering. What is that? That is physical weathering and the second is chemical weathering. Now the breaking down of rocks is known as weathering, and wind, water, frost helps in transporting of soil to places. Now we'll understand what is physical weathering. Physical weathering is the process of breaking of rocks into smaller pieces. Breaking of rocks due to smaller pieces, and this changes do not involve any characteristic change in the original rock. Now physical weathering allow the rock which is bigger in size, that will be changes into smaller size, and this does not allow any change in its, like change in the original rock. Now these are caused by the temperature change, frost and all. So temperature will be changed, then frost means like that is ice breaking will be there, ice. Now temperature change like sudden heat will be there or sudden cold will be there, they also allows the breaking of these rocks also. Now rocks might, you might have seen that a huge rock is broken into two part, as you can see in the picture. Now this will happen due to like lightning also, when lightning occurs. So that is again one of the cause of physical weathering only. That is one of the cause of the physical weathering only. Now chemical weathering is the process which exists of mineral are broken down into mineral components. Now most of the elements, you are knowing that they are, we found most of the elements in this in the form of rocks only, which will be separated by using chemicals and useful element we can take it out from it, like ore, in the form of ore, like different elements like bauxite ore is present, from which we are going to chemically we make it pure, and then we can extract the original element from that. So that is a reason of chemical weathering. Now chemical weathering is the process which exists of minerals and are broken down into mineral components. Now water is the main agent used in this process. Now water is not a chemical thing I'm talking about, but chemical water is most often used to clear that particular part of stone or rock, and then it will be used to clear the such part. Now soil, what is weather? The weather condition prevailing in an area in general or over a long period of time. Now climate affects by the rain, wind, temperature of a place. Now soil of a place is get affected by this climate change or climate effects only, by rain, wind, temperature of a place and all. So what is weather? The weather condition prevailing in an area in general or over a long period of time. Now characteristics of the parent rock. Parent rock is the parent rock refer to the original rock from which the certain part will be broken down. Now it is not like that the parent rock refers to the original rock from which something else was formed. Now it is mainly used in the context of soil formation. These rock particles, due to the action of heat, temperature, wind and different climatic changes, affect the different climate elements affect that rock, and it started deteriorating. Like in a particular area, when every year we suffer of flood, we are suffering from flood, so that flood will be responsible for the deteriorating of the soil of that place, or rocks which were goes inside the flood, that also started deteriorating. Now that is only water. In flood the water only overflows, but due to a continuous process, since this is repeating again and again, that is why it will become a reason of that. Now it is mainly used in the context of soil formation, where the parent rock normally has a large influence on the nature of the resulting soil. So it is mainly used in the context of soil formation, where the parent rock normally has a large influence on the nature of resulting soil. So these are the characteristics. Now what are the main factors affecting soil formation? So for forming soil formation, or soil formation will be done by using certain factors like climate, characteristics of parent rock, slope of land is also is one of the reason. Now climate, the weather condition like the rain, wind, etc. plays an important role in loosening the soil. Increasing of pressure can also make the rocks to crack. Now rocks are also worn down by wind. Soil formation is faster in hot and slow in winter season. See, इन विंटर सीजन वी विल बी गेटिंग टेम्परेचर विल बी लेसर, द टेम्परेचर गोज डाउन, विच इज़ अगेन अगेंस्ट विद दैट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सॉइल ओनली. सो दिस क्लाइमेट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वेदर कंडीशन लाइक रेन, विंड एक्सेट्रा प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन लूजिंग द सॉइल. देन इंक्रीजिंग ऑफ प्रेशर कैन ऑल्सो कॉज मेक द रॉक्स टू क्रैक. नाउ रॉक्स आर ऑल्सो वॉर्न डाउन बाय विंड. सॉइल फॉर्मेशन इज फास्टर इन हॉट एंड स्लो इन विंटर सीजन. नाउ वॉट आर द डिफरेंट स्टेजिज ऑफ सॉइल फॉर्मेशन? सॉइल फॉर्मेशन, नाउ सी दिस इज एन इंट्रोडक्टरी क्लास एंड यू जस्ट गो थ्रू ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट फ्रॉम अ बुक ऑल्सो. वॉट इज वेदरिंग, हाउ वेदर, हाउ क्लाइमेट अफेक्ट सॉइल फॉर्मेशन, वॉट आर द डिफरेंट स्टेजिज ऑफ सॉइल फॉर्मेशन, ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू जस्ट गो थ्रू विद दैट विद योर book content also. Now soil formation, what are the different stages of soil formation? That is, weathering is the physical or chemical process. Yes, weathering is the physical or chemical process. That is a chemical process or physical process, like it depends upon the climate change. So weathering is the physical or chemical process. Small rocks continue to undergo weathering, causing large piece of parietal rocks. So small rocks continues to undergo weathering. Weathering means they will be deteriorating in small pieces from a huge rock. From a huge rock, it will be deteriorating into the small rocks, and then these small rocks are the same as of the huge rocks and large pieces of parietal rocks. The characteristic of both the rocks will be same. The characteristic of both the rocks will be same. The big rock which is deteriorating into small the small rocks which continues to undergo weathering, causing large piece of parietal rocks. Now here the characteristics of the small rock which broken down from a big rock, the characteristic of both is same. Like what all? Characteristic of the big rock, that is same as of the same characteristic we will be finding in the small rocks also, which is deteriorating, which we will be getting after deterioration of that particular soil. Now mineral and salts seep deeper into the ground along with water. Since wind, rainfall, such are the reason of it, so minerals and salts which are present in the soil, that goes deep inside that soil and seep deeper into the ground along with the water. So that will be there. So soil formation stages are there. Weathering is the physical or chemical process first. That is, weathering means here weathering consists of all, like breaking off rocks, wind, rain, all these temperature variation and all these things will be such kind of a cause. Now small rocks continues to undergo weathering. Small rocks continue to undergo weathering, causing large pieces of parietal rocks. Now mineral and salts seep deeper into the ground along with water. Now mineral and salts seep deeper into the ground along with water. minerals and salt, they go inside the salt into the ground along with water. So that will be there, mineral and rocks, salts seep deeper into the ground along with the water. Then we have next, like humus and topsoil. Humus is the organic compound. Humus is what? Humus is the organic compound of soil formed by the decomposition of leaves and other plants material by soil microorganism. Humus, how humus plays an important role to make fertile, to make the topsoil of that fertile. So here humus is the organic compound or organic component of soil which is formed by the decomposition of leaves and other plant material by soil microorganism. Now humus makes the topsoil more fertile. This layer consists of humus and fine particle of dust and sand. Now here humus is the organic component of soil which is formed by the decomposition of leaves and other plants material by soil microorganism. So humus is the organic component of soil formed by the decomposition of leaves and other plant material by soil microorganism. So now horizon contains weathered rock. Now it is very difficult to dig more than this layer. The line at which the earth's surface and the sky appear to meet, that is horizon. And bedrock is what? The lower most layer and consists of parent rock. Now this layer is mainly consists of soil. Now this layer is also soft and can hold water. Horizon lies just above the topsoil, which is rich. Now what is subsoil? Subsoil is rich in mineral that sweep down along with the water. Just now we have seen that that is minerals sweep inside the soil. So that mineral was contained by this subsoil and it also consists of fine particles of soil. Now parental rock undergoing changes. So you might have heard about it that this Himalaya or the height of this particular hill is getting deteriorating due to wind, due to rain, due to weather changing. So why is that so? So that is due to these physical changes or the weathering is one of the cause of this changing of a parental rock. Now parental rock keep on undergoing change, like wind is there, rainfall always will be there, temperature is one of the constraint to get change this parental rock. So this keep on changing, like what is there in that parental rock or what is there in that characteristic is same of both parental rock and then the rocks particles which we get it after detroiting or decaying of that soil, that will be same. The characteristics are same, but they keep on changing this undergoing change. So soil horizon, if I'll see, if you can see this diagram, very important diagram to understand what are the different layers of soil and how it is important. O level of the soil horizon is, O is your humus. Then A, that is zone of leaching of soluble salt. So A region is the topsoil, but minerals which are present in the topsoil that will be taken up by B level of soil, that is zone of accumulation of salts due to flood. due to uneven heating, due to high temperature, or mainly due to flood, the minerals goes into the third level, that is B, and or it will be absorbed, these minerals will be absorbed by this subsoil. Then we have weathered parent material like bedrock weathered parent material like rocks which are deteriorating, that will be collected here. Now gradational contact, then fresh parent material bedrock. So bedrock which is present inside the soil, that will be deteriorating, and then it will be collecting up to some extent, up to some part of it, and then we will be getting this fresh parent material rock. So these are the certain layer of soil, or a picture of soil which will help you to understand how different layers we will be finding in soil. Like humus contains all the dead and decaying plants and dried leaves and all that we will be getting. Then a part or the a layer of soil, that is zone of leaching of soluble salt, that is topsoil. Now zone of accumulation of salt, that is subsoil, that is all the mineral was soaked by this B layer. So here again one picture which will help you to understand layers you can see in this soil clearly. First, that is dark green layer that is containing humus, that is dead and decaying plants, some parts of like some part of like fertile soil we will be finding. Then top soil we have. Now top soil is what? Top soil is like which is mainly used in agriculture. This top soil is mainly used in agriculture. Then minerals from the topsoil is absorbed by the subsoil due to flood or some other reason. Then lower region, that is your bedrock, everything is going to collected there in that bedrock. So that will be there. Okay, so these are the certain part of it, like humus, topsoil, subsoil, bedrock. We're going to learn the sequence of it. What all is the sequence of it? Sequence of like this humus, then upper layer we will finding out humus only in the upper layer of the soil. Then topsoil, which is the most fertile soil, which is used by the agriculture, which is used in the agriculture purposes, which is used by the farmers. Then subsoil means the minerals which are present due to flood or due to wind or due to some certain temperature, it will be absorbed by the subsoil. Then bedrock is the thick rock-like structure which we are going to find it out here. So subsoil, bedrock, topsoil and humus will be there. So just go through all these slides as well as the picture, the diagram which were there. Go through the introduction of this chapter from your book, and we will be discussing next part. Next part in tomorrow's class. So today we have done introduction of soil, what all are the causes which is there when in deteriorating the soil, how the soil is getting deteriorating, how humus help to increase the fertility of the soil, what is the difference between humus and the topsoil, subsoil, what all will be present in subsoil. So today I'll be finishing the class. You just go through the introductory part of this chapter 9 and we'll be discussing the rest of the part tomorrow. So that's all for today, children. Have a good day.